On Friday, the second season of Netflix's House of Cards wrapped filming in Washington, D.C. and the Baltimore area. Focused on Kevin Spacey's power-hungry Congressman Francis Underwood, the Emmy-winning show also depicts a young journalist who sleeps with Spacey's character, creating a cutting portrait of Washington journalism.
How about Slugline?
What's Slugline?
If I said Politico wanted to hire me, what would you say?
I would say that that piques my interest.
6 months from now, Slugline will be what Politico was a year and a half ago.
I spoke in Baltimore with the show's executive producer, creator, and showrunner, Beau Willimon, asking him about the state of the media in the show's second season. Beau Willimon, executive producer, creator, House of Cards, welcome to Reliable Sources.
Thanks for having me, Eric.
So one of the things I love about House of Cards is that you talk about the media and you depict how the media works. And I'll be honest, when in the early episodes, I was worried about a stereotypical view of journalists. You had this young blogger coming up. And what I love, too, is by the end of the season, we see her really teaming up with an old school investigative journalist to try and really make an impact. And was there a message there about where you think media is going?
Well, you're talking about Janine Skorsky, who was the senior political correspondent for the Washington Herald, our fictional paper. Mm-hmm. But actually, at that point in the season, Janine has made the move to Slugline as well.
Right.
You know, so you have two journalists who have left a prestigious newspaper in order to work somewhere that would be the equivalent of like a BuzzFeed or a Politico. And I think you see that happening more and more in the mainstream media, where you're creating a new mainstream. And so I think reporters will tend to gravitate where they have the most impact. And one of the questions our show poses is, where is that impact? What form does it take, and how has it changed the face of news?
Now, I know for some of the critics who reviewed this show, the story twist where you have the reporter sleeping with a source and to get access to get scoops was something that troubled them.
Sure.
I wondered, and now I know that was a storyline in the original British version of the series as well. What did you think when you had to adapt?
Now remember, she's not sleeping with him entirely just to get sources. In fact, that's four episodes in before that happens. And what they have is a very professional, transactional relationship before that, where she says, if you give me access and you give me news, then I will print what you want. Now, you were talking about a form of journalistic ethics there that is questionable, if you can call it ethics at all. But our goal was not to tell the story of Woodward and Bernstein. Our goal was to say the land of media is just like any other profession, where ambitious people will do anything to get what they want. So the idea of noble, ethical journalism was not something that we were trying to dramatize. And we don't mean for Zoe Barnes to be a template for the way that all journalism works. In fact, it's the exception, just like Francis Underwood is the exception. But we weren't going to treat the media with kid gloves the same way we don't treat politicians with kid gloves.
One of my pet theories about why other TV shows, I feel, haven't dealt with journalism so well is because often it's boring. All we're doing is making phone calls and looking through papers. Was that a challenge, too, to bring some drama to a process that might be boring on its face?
Really, the focus is on the characters. What is happening emotionally and dramatically for the characters? And whether they are a journalist or they work on the Hill or it's Freddie at the barbecue joint, if the characters are compelling and what's happening to them is important to them, and that's conveyed to the audience, then it will be important and interesting to the audience. So, there are times, of course, where we exaggerate things or condense or accelerate things for the sake of drama, but authenticity is really important. And yes, you're always walking a fine line between, if I were being absolutely 100% authentic here, it would take 4 months to break this story, and there'd be a lot of sitting behind a desk making a lot of phone calls. But I think if you could capture the essence, the most dramatic portions, of that endeavor, then you are telling the truth, but you're also doing it in a way that's entertaining.
So, Beau, you've said in previous interviews that media often just reflects what's bubbling around under the surface of society. So, as we stand here today, what do you think is bubbling around in society now, and how do you translate that into a script for House of Cards?
I think the media doesn't shape the conversation. I think that they report the conversation, and the best journalists can anticipate where the conversation is going.
Now, you guys did just wrap your second season, and I know
yesterday.
You're a guy who tends to keep your cards close to the vest, but can you tell us anything about what we're going to see in the next season, and particularly how the media is going to be featured?
Absolutely not. Yeah.
Okay.
No, I sort of have a blanket policy. We don't discuss anything that's coming ahead because one of the things that happens when you release an entire season in one day is that you're already contending with spoiler alerts from the first day of
right.
release. So we don't want to do anything to sort of. Get that process going before day one. So
I totally understand. We'll get out the torture devices and we'll figure out what's happening later. Well, Beau Willimon, executive producer, showrunner, creator of Netflix's House of Cards, thank you so much for joining us on Reliable Sources.
Thanks for having me, Eric. It's been a pleasure. Yeah.
That's it for this edition of Reliable Sources. I'm Eric Deggans. By the way, if you miss a program, you can now go on iTunes on Mondays and check out our podcast. Just search for Reliable Sources in the iTunes store.